Hello everybody and welcome back to Amazing Tech for All. Today we are setting up a media server called Jellyfin on TrueNAS. This is a media server that can manage all your content or your personal content on your home network. Okay, let's start. Okay, let's log into TrueNAS. Excuse me. Yeah, okay, I have it saved. Let's go into there. Let's see. Oh, sorry. Username should be TrueNAS admin. And we should then be able to log in. So the first thing we need to do is add a data set. So a storage for where everything will be mounted. Add it under main, and we're just going to call it Jellyfin. Right, and here we can make it Samba. So okay, I think that should be fine. Let's save it. Okay, and we can start the Samba service. Fine. Secondly, we'll create some user accounts to manage this. So first we want to go to add a user account. We'll just call it user1 and give it a password. And what we need to do is make sure that the Samba user is connected. Is ticked. Right, this user will have permissions on. We'll give it the Jellyfin folder. Right, save. We'll confirm and continue. Right, so now we want to be able to see where this content is accessible, so for this service. So let's open a network point and we'll just go to connect to it via SMB, and we will do the IP address, which is 192. Yes, there we go. We'll test it. Yes, I think that should actually. Let's just confirm. That is incorrect. Okay, so we're going to go into SMB on Windows. We will have to do a different, say, Jellyfin. Yeah, and connect. Yes, and the user is user1. And the password is the password you just set. Okay, so now we can create a folder. Let's call it movies. And create another one. Photos. And maybe a third one for music videos. Okay, so now we've created these folders and we can go back to the TrueNAS interface. So to get Jellyfin to work, we need to go to apps, and then we'll have to go to discover, and here we can do a search and we'll say Jellyfin. There we go. We'll click on the app and we'll say install. So there's very a few things that need to be configured over here, the one being the region. So me again being in South Africa, I will select South African one, and then I will scroll down the web UI port. We will publish this on 8099. Yes, we'll the host IP. Let's just see, but we don't really need to change that. And we can go to the storage, where here we'll go add additional storage. We'll select Samba from here. And the mount path is going to be This is what is going to be inside Jellyfin itself. And the server is 192.168.122.186 in this case. And the path, let's see, the path is Jellyfin. Sorry, that's a misspelling. And then the user is the user we just created. One, and the password. And I believe that's all we need to do to make this work. If you have GPU pass-through or a GPU, then you can enable that functionality. But that is not currently, this hardware does not facilitate that. Okay, so we're pulling down the app. We're creating it. This may take a few seconds. And once it's up, then it'll give us a opportunity to click on the web UI button to open Jellyfin itself. Okay, so the download of the image has now completed, and now we are seeing the status change from deploying to running. So if we click on web UI, it will ask us to create, or there's a menu that you'll have to go through, or what they used to call a wizard. So we'll click on that. It'll give it a username. I'll just call it user one again. Set my password for convenience sake. Tend to, for demonstrations, I use the same password generally. And here we go. We can add media. So the type of media we're going to select here, it's movies, and we'll select movies. All right. Here we'll go to SMB and we'll select the movies over here and click OK. And then there's a few things that you can change here, download language, etc., etc. These things are, most of them are optional, and they will end up producing clips and so on for yourself, right? So you click on OK. And then we can add another one. We can maybe click on the one for photos. See, home videos and photos. There we go. We'll add one for the photographs. We'll click on here. These will be the same ones you created under this folder. So it will just show up there, right? On the Samba share. Or in the case of Windows, it will be the Windows share. So we'll click photos. Okay. And we'll click OK over here again. And now we'll click on next. Say, doesn't really matter. We'll just click OK. Allow remote control of the server. That's fine. It's good. And finished. Now we'll have to log in with that user account. User. And the password. Sign in. I'm saying remember this. Now you'll find that the content doesn't have anything in it. So as you can see, the media does not contain any content yet. So if I go into the various folders, it doesn't show any information, anything there. So the folders that we were creating before, these ones, sorry, I've created some folders to have some content available for us to use. These I pulled down from Pixabay, pixabay.com, I think it is. So we can just copy those to the folder that is that we've created earlier and that we've now connected to, right, on the TrueNAS server. The same goes for videos that I have over here. So I'll pull some, copy these videos and copy it to the share, which is now configured in Jellyfin. Right. Let's paste that over there as well. This will take a few seconds. Yes. And now we will go back to Jellyfin. So if we look at the content inside here, let's firstly click on the dashboard. And let's see if a rescan will do anything. There we go. We are scanning the media. Scanning all the libraries. And let's go back. And there we have all the images and the content that we've uploaded. So if I click on an image, it will allow me to connect to show all the images in the that's in that folder. And I think you can either click or you can use your direction keys. That does that beautifully. Yes. If we press the escape button, nothing happens. Let's just see what how do we get out of here? Uh-huh. Oh, there we go. There is the little button on the top. And the same applies for videos. Videos that I've now pulled from Pixabay as well. And these can now show up beautifully on Jellyfin. So now that we've got all the videos and the images in the various folders, we can also add additional functionality by adding an image to this. For example, we can say edit image, and we'll go select the image. Yes, there's one of them. That's fine for the pictures, and that will be a picture that will be present for the photos, the home videos and photos. And let's, if we refresh the screen, it should show that one. And we'll just select another one for the videos. So we'll pick one, browse, and we can go to the mountain. Yes. And upload. And there we go. So if we close that and refresh the screen, there we go. Beautiful. Anyway, for future videos, please like and subscribe if you liked what you found over here, and we will continue on with more videos in the future. Thank you very much.